They do that and make him stand there and fight. It's a wrap.
Who is Lomachenko fighting next?
Jorge Linares, the 135 champion.
Do you think Linares could beat him?
I think Linares has got a chance. He's definitely got a chance. He's fast. He's slick. He can punch. His problem is his skin betrays him. Because he cuts up like crazy. He cuts up too fast. And when he sees blood, a lot of times, when he sees blood, he loses common sense. He starts fighting with his heart on his shoulder. You know what I mean? And that's what usually gets him in trouble, you know. But he's definitely got the skill and the experience, you know. I think it's going to be a great fight. I mean, as long as it lasts, you know.
Let me see this, Eric. You worked with James Toney for many, many years. Yeah. Anybody today remind you of James Toney?
Not really.
Nobody like that today?
I see a couple guys do one or two moves like James. But to have the composure and the mindset and the willingness to run through fire with gasoline draws on, no.
But how about fighters today?
Didn't give a fuck. He fought a wounded gorilla in a phone booth. That motherfucker didn't give a fuck. You know what I'm saying? He wasn't scared of nobody.
Okay, 160 to heavyweight.
160 to heavyweight. Yep.
But what I like about James, and we don't have a lot of that today, he talked crazy smack. Nobody talks smack like in your era. People were.
Yeah, but if you can back it up, it ain't smack.
Yeah. No, but people don't talk today at all. Everybody says
because they all can't back it up.
That's not true. You guys like Adrien Broner. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but Adrien can't back it up.
I mean, he can. He can sometimes.
Against a guy, a midget. A midget that can't hurt him or threaten him, yeah, he can back it up.
He's a four-division champ.
But you put him in there with the guy that he's fighting at 147.
He's a four-division champ.
Against who? Come on now, go back now.
Okay, I'll tell you.
Let's go back. Everybody he fought for at least three of those fucking division championships were little bitty motherfuckers coming up to his weight. Everybody he fought before he went up to 47 and they robbed Paulie and took that shit from him to give to that motherfucker. Yeah, yeah. Everybody prior to that were little bitty motherfuckers.
You're right about that.
All right? And he had a size advantage and he had a power advantage. When he moved up to 47, all that changed. All that changed. Now you see him coming out like he's going to do something. But as soon as somebody put the pressure on him, he folds up. The last fight I saw him in, I was like impressed that he actually tried to fight. All the way through the fight.
You're talking about Mikey?
Yeah.
When you fought Mikey.
But Mikey was busting that ass. Yeah. You know, I think he was fighting more out of survival than anything. You know what I mean? Because if he slowed down with Mikey, it was going to be ugly. You know what I mean?
Who else do you think talks against smack? Did the Charlos talk smack? Or they're just mean?
They never stop talking smack. They always talk smack.